In the last episode of the On Deck channel, Stephen and I sat down to discuss the scope of this new Leopard 50 project. While he then gave us a tour of the boat and its beginning state of being torn down for all the installs and the work that the yacht rigger is going to do on the boat. But in this episode, we're going to be hearing from Stephen to get an update on what's been going down this week on the Leopard 50, while also hearing from Marine Master Electrician Andre on this advanced chiller system that they're installing, among a few other things.
All right, so latest update. We have a lot going on. It's funny, it doesn't really look like a whole lot has happened since we last shot here. But we have started working on the mast wiring. Of course, you can see this is all kind of hanging down here now, just because we're disconnecting and running some different wires for that. And still working on running some wires for the plotter and the new VHF, the Vesper VHF that's going to be going in. We have the new MFD that's been mounted upstairs, so that cutout has been done, a nice new big MFD. The air conditioning install is still underway. We have a lot going on there because we're running new ducting and having to install air handlers and the AC unit itself. We did have to cut through the seating over there, the base of the seating, so we could get the one air handler in place to not be obstructing the cushions. So that was an interesting little challenge, but we got it figured out. The rest of the AC project, the main compressor is in its little hole. It's very tight. I know you got some good footage of that, so that's going to be cool to see. And the battery install continues. So we do have the distributor going in here with the batteries. Battery wiring is starting to come together, and lots of bits and pieces because we have to obviously connect the batteries to the main DC panel as well as the inverter. So there's lots of wiring going back and forth, and it's a slow process to do it right, but we're getting at it. We are getting ready to run a whole bunch of wires up there. We've got the radar going up. We have the night vision camera that's going up there. We are adding some sprayer lights, and we are modifying the masthead light and making that a tricolor anchor combination with a light sensor compared to just the anchor light only option. So that means this owner will be able to run their nav lights at night on the masthead and not have any forward lights on the boat. So I actually prefer that because it minimizes any potential for night blindness, like when you're sailing. I don't like when my bow lights light up the sails when I'm trying to see things. So it's going to be interesting. There's a whole bunch of conduit in the mast, and we're going to have one guy up the rig, one guy on the bottom, feeding wires up and down, but not really a massive project, but it'll make some really, really significant changes.
Very interesting installation today on this Leopard 50. We're doing a Thermodynamica VRV system. This is very different than other air conditioning systems on boat in that they are kind of like a home mini split with multiple heads. So there's a central compressor here that sends refrigerant through lines across the boat to air handlers, which we can go down and check out in a minute. Very, very efficient air conditioner. This unit right here is rated for 55,000 BTUs, and the maximum draw is roughly 2,800 watts, which is incredible. Looking forward to putting this to the test to really measure the performance. It comes at a premium. It is a high-end system. We can remote into the display to do some troubleshooting, diagnostics, or even control. The user can remote into the unit and adjust the temperature as needed, turn it on or off. If we come down here, I'll show you an air handler. On this boat, there's going to be two 30,000 BTU air handlers at each corner of the boat that service each hull. So here we ran the refrigerant lines underneath the boat, which is evidently a lot smaller to run than duct work. And then we have an air handler here. This air handler is going to supply this owner's suite, as well as the head over here, and also the forward cabin in this hull. Oh, actually, we also have a vent that goes up to the salon from this air handler. So very high-end system, very very advanced, and looking forward to firing this guy up.
Sweet.
They're gonna be getting that thing down here through this companionway down into the, there's like a storage locker area here on this port side hull. Awesome.
I told you I'm gullible. You're so great.
What am I doing?
I'm literal as well. I think we're going to carry the unit and pass it sort of into Andre. But
I'm going to guide it, but I'm also going to need your help. So somebody's going to have to support from the bottom and lift up as we kind of guide it in its resting place.
What's going on?
Just hanging out in the bowels of the boat.
He's got a boat bite.
I can rip it out as long as I don't damage anything else, but it's in a slot that's...
I think you're good if you get a rip.
Hey, watch your fingers though.
Yeah, just add a little glue right there.
What? So pick it up, turn it this way, rotate it 90, so turn it 90, then flip it 90.
You don't need to just walk back. Just flip it. You're going to go.
Who, Danny? Don't trust the immigrants. The immigrant said that.
Okay. Hold on, we got a lot going on right now. Hold on, it's caught on the vent.
Okay, I got it.
Okay. Yep.
Holy.
Slider.
Oh, sir.
Oh, yeah. Beautiful.
Thank you.
Wow.
Nice.
That is nice. All right.
So I have a little bit of footage of something that I wanted to highlight that I thought was really pretty cool. While I talk about that, here's a little bit of footage of Frank doing the install for the multifunction display for the chart plotter up at the helm position here on the Leopard 50. Brian, the co-owner of the Yacht Rigger, was basically made aware of the fact that this new inverter that's going to be delivered to this boat is a Victron inverter. It weighs nearly 200 pounds, and it's 15,000 watts. That is completely crazy. I've never seen an inverter over like 3,000 watts, so I'm looking forward to seeing this bad boy in the flesh. But the interesting thing is that the inverter has mounting holes that are the same and the same size hardware and everything as if it was one of the smaller inverters of like 2,000 or 3,000 watts. So there's an approach that most installers would take, and they would do like a wood a wood deck that they would make, that they would then mount the inverter onto that deck and then mount that wooden deck down onto the boat itself. I mean, you know, there's a lot of ways to skin the cat, but that's one of the ways that a lot of installers would do it. But that is not good enough for Brian. So what Brian has opted to do instead is make an entire aluminum custom frame to make a drop-in frame that 15,000 watt inverter will be able to slide into and lock down into place. And then the tolerances are gonna be as such to where the frame itself will be able to act as a giant heat sink. So I just happened to see him crawling around in the boat, getting just the very beginning phases of that done. You can see that here. And there's going to be more on that next week about how he's doing that frame and then them actually installing it. I'll make sure I get that, along with just the inverter being delivered and all that. And speaking of next episode, in that next episode, we're also going to hear not just a general update on the boat, but there has been an issue that the Yacht Rigger is being faced with, and it's quite a large setback regarding the rigging, and that's going to be an interesting challenge to see how these guys get around that and still meet the deadline of getting this boat wrapped up and finished, because this customer, Neil, and his family are, you know, they're up against some hard timelines that they got to be able to get out and get underway to be able to meet some things that they have set up for themselves and their family. So we're going to hear more about that in the next episode. If you guys are finding this useful at all, please like, comment, subscribe. Any of that interaction really helps this little baby channel start to grow. So thank you guys for watching, and I will see you next time on the On Deck channel.